Hey everyone, I'm Samyak Agarkar and welcome to Agark Media Academy. This is the 14th tutorial in Blender tutorial series for beginners. In the last tutorial, we saw how to use texture coordinates and mapping nodes inside of Blender node editor to give scale up and scale down effects to the materials on our objects. But in the last tutorial, we did not learn how to use custom texturing or custom UV editing. So in this tutorial, we are going to learn just that. So here we have the UV editing panel, which we are going to extensively use. Now, let's first understand how UV editing is working for the default cube. So this is our default cube, and we saw how the texturing works for the default cube, right? So let's go to the UV editing panel. Now here we have basically two windows. One of them is the UV editor window, and the second one is the default 3D viewport, right? Now here in the 3D viewport, we have three coordinates and one coordinate system, that is X, Y and Z coordinate system, right? Here we have a coordinate system of U and V. So one of them is U, this one is U, this one is V. We don't need to understand exactly which one is U and which one is V, but basically two-dimensional coordinate system in the left hand side and three-dimensional coordinate system in the right hand side. So now, as we can see here, we have not selected, by default we are in the edit mode for the object that we have selected. If I have not selected any vertices, then we see nothing here, right? Now as soon as I select a face, let's go to the face select mode. As soon as I select a face, you can see this block here, right? So this block is basically the mapping of this 3D object onto this 2D texture. So let's consider that, imagine that this one is the texture, right? This box, this square is the default texture. And this face, as soon as we select this face, we see that this face of the cube is being mapped to this cube, this square on the this texture, right? The same goes for other textures or the other faces also. This face is mapped here. This face is mapped here, this face is mapped on the top, this face is mapped on the right side, and I think this one is remaining. This face is at the bottom, and one more face, this one is here, right? And if I select all the faces, then I can see six faces right here in the UV coordinate system, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So it is being mapped in the plus way. So basically, we have all mapped the textures from here to here in this fashion, right? Now let's do the same thing for some other object. Let's delete this default cube. Let's add a sphere, a UV sphere, and let's go to the UV editing panel. Now as soon as I select control, as soon as I have already selected all of the faces, you can see how it is being mapped on this panel, right? So the edges are just triangles. These are not squares. The edges, the top faces in the UV editor here, as you can see, these are not squares. These are triangles, and the same goes for the bottom one, right? So the top faces are triangles, and the bottom faces are also triangles. As you can see here, these are triangles, not squares, and all others are squares. So this is all about a UV sphere, right? Let's try some other. Let's say let's try for the cylinder, and let's go to the UV editing panel. So here you can see the side panel is being stretched out here, this one, and the top circle and the bottom circle is being stretched out here, right? So this is how UV editing works. So we can basically, what we can do is, so if I'm in the face select mode, if I just select this one face, so you can see that this face is being mapped to here in the texture. I can just select this face, and I can just scale it up, scale it down, or I can just grab it somewhere here or there, right? So this is how we can by ourselves use the UV editing mode. So if I just select this face, so I know this face is here, I can just select this face and grab it somewhere here, and it will still work. Now if I go select all, then now here you can see the objects are being transformed. So initially we had this complete strip, but now we remove this face and put it here, and we also move the circle from here to here, right? So this is how we can do UV editing, and now we will see how it affects the texture of the cubes or the texture of the object. So let's go to the shading panel, and quickly we will give the same shading to this also, the same shading that we used earlier. Now last time we by default had the principal VSDF shader here. If we don't have, we can just click new and it will give the principal VSDF shader and material output. Now let's just quickly connect all those textures, image texture. These are the same textures that we used earlier. Open. It was in downloads, textures and color for the base color. And we also saw we can use the node wrangler add-on to give the texture node, texture coordinate and mapping node. So I just select this texture and control T and it is already there, right? Now let's duplicate this. Shift D for duplication. Let's connect this to our roughness map and change the image to the roughness image and join the vector to vector this way. Let's just duplicate one more time because we want the normal map. Now normal cannot be directly connected here, so we are just going to add a normal map. Normal map, put it in between color to color, normal to normal, and let's change the texture to the normal map, this one, and just bring the vector from here to from here to here. Good, we can just select this and move it away so that we can see it properly. Now this is being done, right? This is how it looks. Now let's go to the UV editing panel now, and right now we are in the we may not be able to see it just here, but right now we are in the by default solid mode. So let's go to the rendered mode, Z and rendered mode. So this is our rendered mode, or we can go to material preview mode because we just want to look at the materials, right? So in the material preview mode we have this one. Now here the normal map is open. We can just change the map from here. So now we have the color map open. Now let's go to the face select mode. Let's select this face. We know that this face is here. Now if I just select this face in the UV editor, and if I move, you can see here, right here, you can see right here that the texture changes. Now this is because the mapping is changing. So now you can understand clearly that this texture, this bounding box, the texture that is inside the bounding box is being replaced here in the 3D viewport. So this is how UV mapping actually works. So that is all about UV mapping. So if it is here, we can just change it here, and now all the texturing we can change in this fashion. If we want to rotate it, we can just rotate it. So here you can see, if I'm just putting it somewhat diagonally, then the diagonal texture will be available right here. I just select this face again. I just select the face here in the UV editor panel and scale it up. Then you can see more bricks are being embossed there. Now, one thing to note here that this one is the tileable texture. So even if we move the texture, this box outside of the texture, still it will be repeated because it is a tileable texture always. Or I can just scale it down to have just one block right here. I can also scale, let's rotate it and let's straighten it up. I can also scale in just one direction, let's say X, and grab it right here. So here you can see that though here in the UV editor panel the block is diagonal, the brick is horizontal, but here the horizontal nature is not available because here we have a rectangle or parallelogram here, but let's say it's a rectangle and here we have a square. So rectangle image is being squashed to or stretched in to a square image. So that's why we can see some stretching going on here, the inward stretching going on here. Inversely, if I just move it right here and make it a taller texture, and let's grab it right here, then we can see that the opposite is true now. The smaller texture is being stretched to a square texture. So that is how UV editing and UV mapping works. So I think this is all for this video. In the next video, we will be learning how to actually create these maps. So how to convert these 3D images or 3D objects to 2D textures. So here we already have this. So here you can see all these faces that are being mapped here. In the next tutorial, we will be learning how to by ourselves manually map all these things by us. So that is it in this tutorial. I think this tutorial was not really much to do, but just to learn and just to understand the concept about how UV editing actually works and how we can map the textures using the UV editing panel and just change the materials and the mapping of the materials onto the 3D objects. See you in the next tutorial. Till then, keep smiling and keep learning.